Pitsnoggle, Young, Ganzi across the front line, Airbear and Collins in the backcourt. Jim Burr, Pat Driscoll, Glenn Mayboard, the officiating crew. 14,000 on hand at the Coliseum. And we're underway with West Virginia controlling the tip. Quick pump, Young off the rim, and the rebound tracked down by Dean.
And keep an eye on Dean. He likes to push the basketball up the floor to really make things happen for Louisville.
Jenkins stolen by Airbear. Airbear on a stop and go. Collins kick out. And now West Virginia will set up half court.
A little bit of a matchup right now for Louisville defensively to start things off. It gives you the impression that it's a man-to-man, but you'll see guys kick. There goes Jenkins, number 11, at top of the key. You see him pushing, and there's a little confusion right now.
Young to the corner. Airbear, drive. Ganzi, corner. For three.
Shot goes down from the corner, but the problems for Louisville at that matchup defense started at the top of the key with the inconsistency. Another deflection out front. But a good recognition by West Virginia. They will pick you apart and use the entire shot clock if need be.
On a dump down inside, Palacios. Ball movement. This is Johnson, and a foul called. As Johnson put it on the floor, Collins trying to scrape the ball free and picks up the personal.
West Virginia, they're 1-3-1. One thing to look for is Collins, the smallest guy for West Virginia, plays underneath the basket.
Here's Palacios looking for the open man. New shot clock to work with for Louisville. West Virginia in front, 3-0. Turnaround jumper. Palacios with a smooth stroke.
A little change up defensively there by West Virginia, and obviously Louisville taking advantage of it. Whenever you see the zone, look for the middle of the floor. Off the dribble from the perimeter or looking to the middle of the floor. Two good looks against zones.
Airbear can handle it, as he just showed, getting it across half court. Spread the floor. Collins, Pitsnoggle, catch and shoot, off the mark for three. Tyquan Dean using the pick and knocks down the jumper for Louisville.
And that's a rhythm shot right there with Dean. If he gets the basketball coming down, he gets one little screen like that. He's very quick to spots, and obviously with good elevation getting off the floor.
Multi-talented performer for the Cardinals, an incredibly hard worker. He'll score, he'll run the team, he'll defend. He's the lead guard for this Louisville squad. And a 4-3 lead for the Cardinals. There's Pitsnoggle. They quickly defend him. Collins is open. Not known for his jump shot. Ganzi trying to mix it up. Out of bounds. It's going the other way to Louisville.
Well, we've seen a little bit of action from West Virginia. Where's the action been? Eyeing on the perimeter, just as if they really don't want to challenge. In the open, we talked about getting the ball down closer. Pitsnoggle in particular, try to get some easier shots.
All of West Virginia's attempts have been from three-point range so far. Williams gets a touch. Dean, good pump. He faked out Airbear. The floater goes down for Tyquan Dean.
And you see the ability of Dean there after shooting the ball from longer range, his previous shot. He baits the defender out and then really attacks quickly. And how about the little bit of a floater? But if you can show ball after shooting a long range jumper, you're going to get defenders really moving quickly.
From the corner. And Young can't convert. Another three-point attempt for West Virginia.
Basics of basketball, and you're going to live by the long shot or die by it. And right there, you see some numbers. Louisville has not even taken a three yet, but 1 of 5. Not going to get it done early on for West Virginia.
In the NCAA regional championship in Albuquerque back in March of 05, Dean hit 7 three-pointers for Louisville, finishing with 23 and propelling the Cardinals into the Final Four. Shot clock is down to 6. Fender. Williams, rainbow delivery doesn't go.
Let's see if Collins can push the ball, get something going a little bit off the break, but pretty good balance by Louisville.
Try to fake out Dean. Collins gives up his dribble and now gets it back. 4 minutes gone by in this first half. A 6-0 run for Louisville. Ganzi, that's a long three. Mike Ganzi was 0-for-6 from three-point range in a loss to Syracuse on Monday night. He was held to 8 points. He has knocked down 2 trays already. Nice look inside, Palacios.
No, but the thing with Ganzi, obviously, is known for that long-range shooting. He's put up 8 this year already against Marquette. He was 8 for 11 for a career high for him. So clearly he can shoot his way out of slumps, and that's the best way to get out of a slump is just keep shooting the ball.
Have you gotten the sense that Ganzi likes playing on CBS?
He's done okay, hasn't he?
Big numbers, yeah. NCAA tournament last year. Here's Air Bear, rims out.
He likes playing in front of us.
Maybe that's it. 8-6. Louisville.
Good step up by Air Bear just then defensively on Dean, recognizing a little better.
Another dump down, Palacios. Oh, he's feeling it. Juan Palacios came in shooting 42% from the field. He is 3 of 3 so far in the first half. 6 points for Palacios.
Allows Louisville, when they hit a bucket too, to come into their 2-2-1 defense full court and now into a matchup again.
Air Bear. They clear it. Pitsnog. Palacios comes out to the perimeter.
See how hard they play Pitsnoggle out there? They know he's not going to drive.
Off the stutter step, Air Bear. Pocket was picked. Numbers now. A 2-on-1 developing. And they can't convert. Jenkins couldn't hold on to it.
Well, that's what happens. Johnson, that trip, had the release. He got the ball. The big guy, you want the small guy handling.
Air Bear. No good on a 3. Cardinals with a 10-6 lead. Nice acceleration by Williams. Open look. Doesn't go down as Palacios trying to extend his range. Ganzi turns the corner and gets hit as he took it to the goal. Ganzi with a slashing move and a foul call. Just underway in Morgantown.
29 threes, which is an NCAA tournament record, so don't be surprised to see more going up this afternoon.
Patrick Beilein has checked in, replacing Frank Young for West Virginia. It's Noggle.
Against the man-to-man, a drive may be in order.
Collins on a feed inside. Here's Pitsnoggle, a post-up, and bank shot goes.
It gives them a little bit of a different look, but one, when we spoke to John Beilein, the coach of West Virginia yesterday, said, that's where we need points. We need Pitsnoggle to get the ball down deep to get us some easier looks and consequently easier buckets.
Jenkins fires, and Ganzi able to snatch the loose ball for West Virginia.
It's just how Ganzi plays.
Air Bear gives it up. Beilein,
very often he makes his first shot. Speak to his dad a little bit, the coach. One thing he says about his son, it's impressive to him how he comes off the bench and is able to hit his West Virginia, but they must, and I mean must, they must balance it up inside and outside.
The freshman Andre McGee has come on for Louisville. Jenkins gives it up. Dean trying to fake out Air Bear. Quick double on him.
Good help there by Collins along the baseline and another deflection.
But McGee able to go back and get it.
That was a mistake just then by Beilein. He tried to tap the ball ahead, did not have possession, and should have caught the ball, and they would have had a bucket down the other end.
Now, should the shot clock have been reset as it did?
Probably not, because here's Beilein in the middle of the floor. Take a look at him. He's coming in here. Now, if he catches that ball, then they have the 2-on-1 coming down this way, but he tries to slap at it and push it down. Some fresh bodies in there. Take a look at 7 seconds left.
They'll work quickly. McGee outside for Dean. Shot clock is down to 4. McGee, side rim, and out of bounds. Well, Louisville has gone a bit cold now, trailing 11-10.
Still showing their full court 2-2-1 look. Most times been sliding back into a matchup zone.
Collins. Beilein, open look. Rims out. Ganzi! Unable to convert. And a rebound ripped down by Palacios.
That's where Ganzi is so good, Ian, in terms of finding slots against the zone and slashing to the middle of the floor and at the basket without the ball to try to follow up.
Andre McGee, the freshman from Moreno Valley, California. Offensive foul. It's going the other way. And it will be Palacios who pushed off on the interior. That's his second personal. So Palacios will sit. He's replaced by the freshman from New Hampshire, Chad Millard, for Louisville.
And Palacios going down there and sitting on the bench is pretty big for Louisville because they need his scoring presence down on the blocks.
Palacios averages 10 points per game. Miller, 2.5 points per game.
But it's also the impact he has on the floor. From a defensive perspective, you have to really focus on him when he gets down there deep.
Darris Nichols has come on for West Virginia. Shot clock is down to 10. Beeline open look. Short for three. Long rebound to McGee. Here's Jenkins attacking, and a blocking foul called on Herbert.
And that's the right call also. Herbert did not establish the position and could not hold his ground and slide to his left quick enough.
Ganzi keeps a picture of that Louisville celebration right on his bathroom mirror to remind him of how this team felt following that loss, leading by 20 early, only to see the Cardinals rally and enjoy that Final Four trip.
Yeah, well, he actually rooms with Patrick Beeline, and Beeline wrote on that picture to remind them, how do you feel?
Right.
To remind them of what it felt like to motivate them for this year, because it's actually taken Coach John Beeline a little while to look at that film. What? Took him into the summer, really, for him to really revisit that.
Even this week, he said it was tough watching bits and pieces of it preparing for this matchup. Inside, Pitsnagel, double team.
He's got to go quicker with that shot.
And the jump hook. On a fadeaway jump hook away from the rim.
He recovered okay, but when you catch it in there as a big guy, you got to catch it and go.
7-0 run. Dean can't end it. He comes up short. West Virginia leads 13-10. Running the floor and the throwdown.
Well, he's fun to watch. He can shoot it from long range. He can run the floor. He's mixing up some inside play also. And he's a little bit of a fan favorite here in West Virginia.
Jenkins on the dish, and he sets up Millard nicely underneath.
Nice job by Jenkins just then. When you bring the ball into the middle of the floor, make sure you get a defender to commit. And as soon as somebody steps in your path, that's a great time to release the ball.
For the UConn-West Virginia game, there were 21 pro scouts on hand. Dancing the jump shot. About 12 pro scouts here today, and a lot of seniors out on the floor.
West Virginia sticking with that 1-3-1 with some double teams along the side, and the baseline move will be pretty patient against it, though.
Dean the ball, no call. Yes, there is a travel as Dean ran into Pitsnagel, and the fourth Louisville turnover of this first half.
And you take a look at Pitsnagel with a little fall away jump hook shot to get that to go down, and then watch the big guy go right to the middle of the floor. Point A to point B, right down the middle of the floor. Quickest spot to get a layup and just outrunning people right there. Take a rest, big fella.
Pitsnagel will get that breather. And Robert Summers, the junior transfer from Penn State, checks in to replace him. We are past the midway point of this first half. 17-12, West Virginia in front of Louisville. Good move by Nichols.
Nichols has given them good punch off the bench also. A solid performer at both ends of the floor. And Ganzi out front. The defense here is very difficult to deal with.
Millard gets hacked. A 13. Chip from Chevy, an American tradition. Millard misses them both.
Well, Millard can give them a little punch off the bench also. He had 11 in a game earlier this year against Nova, so he's pretty active down on the blocks, keeps himself moving.
Young setting things up.
Straight up man-to-man, a little switch defensively here.
Now Nichols with 13 to shoot. West Virginia 18-8 overall, 9-4 in the Big East. Shot clock is down to 4. Nichols, no. And Ganzi able to keep it alive, last touch by Louisville. So West Virginia will retain it. Summers sits. Ganzi joins him. And Pitsnagel checks in along with Alex Ruoff, the freshman from Spring Hill, Florida. Little used first year pro.
And I, an interesting to me too is if you like up and down basketball, you've tuned into the right game. If you're here to watch a free throw shooting clinic, you come to the wrong place. These teams just don't go, especially West Virginia. They've not gone to the line yet, and we've played about 12 minutes almost of action.
Well, West Virginia did not attempt a free throw in that loss to Syracuse on Monday night, 60-58. trying to attack inside. Falling.
That could be a jump.
It is. Yep. And possession arrow goes to Louisville.
You'll see the little double team causes trouble again, and then you get into a panic mode. Next thing you know, you go up in the air. Farley that time leaving his feet, probably going up for a shot, but a good hand defensively.
And Palacios back in there playing with two fouls, forcing his way in. And a foul call. Palacios, every time he's touched the ball, he has been aggressive and has looked to score. Side out, Louisville.
He's a guy they need to score, though. He's had 12 double-figure scoring games this year, so clearly they need to get him established down a little bit closer to the hoop.
Beeline picks up the foul. Here's McGee. And a loose ball foul inside against the Cardinals. McGee could not get that scoop to the hoop to go down. And now West Virginia gets it back with a 7-point lead. And that foul to Farley, the sophomore. Once again, West Virginia handles the pressure with ease. Hasn't really hindered them at all, bringing the ball down the floor. Here's Rule. Extra feed, Pitsnoggle. He puts it in.
And almost a rarity, a sighting, if you will, where two players for West Virginia really attacked that time and ended up both of them going towards the...
John Beilein about it. He said, look, we needed this break. Guys haven't had a chance to exhale of late, having played 5 games in 11 days prior to this break. And they look fresh.
Yeah, they do, and it helps. You get 2 full days pretty much. They tried to give them 2 full days off to regather some of the strength in their legs.
Here's Williams to Jenkins. Louisville having a tough time on the offensive end, except that man, Juan Palacios. He's been a one-man show for Louisville so far with 8 of their 14 points.
Does he ever work to get himself free down low? That time it was 2 passes before he really got an opportunity to use the body position to catch and go with it.
Ruoff remains on the floor. Good shooter, deep range.
It's interesting how you defend West Virginia. You really don't defend them thinking they're going to drive by you. There goes air bear a little bit. He stops and pulls it back out.
Now Nichols looking to make something happen. Air bear with 5 to shoot. Bounce inside. Rejected by Farley. Williams running the floor, a pull-up, book it for 3.
A good reaction just then by Williams coming down the floor to make up for that. It's a defensive end, though. A beautiful job by Farley, but that's what happens sometimes when you get the shot clock working against you. It's a catch and a panic shot rather than a good delivery after a drive.
Terrence Williams, the freshman from Seattle, Washington, shooting 31% from three-point range. Pitsnoggle. Off the mark.
Well, that time they were right open in the middle of the floor. Ruoff did not look to even turn and face the basket at 8 feet away.
Now Ruoff has not been looking for a shot. He's been looking to pass every time he's touched it.
You really have to be aware of what you're doing on the floor, where the defenders are, because if he just turned to the basket last trip, he had a 7-foot jumper wide open.
Inside, Palacios rolling to the rim. Farley can't catch it off the follow.
Nice little tip there by Air Bear too.
Pass out of bounds. 3rd West Virginia turnover.
Well, you watch down deep now. Over here, you're going to see the catch by Ruoff. He realizes that, hey, I only have 2 seconds left. There's not a whole lot I can do. And guess what? Farley recognized that also and went up and put a little hand on it.
Now, Farley is certainly a presence on the interior. It's 6'10, 250. He's gained about 50 pounds since arriving as a freshman at Louisville. 21-17, West Virginia. Ganzi is back on the floor. So is Collins for the Mountaineers. Farley way outside, needs some help. Williams. And the knockaway by Young. Leak out by Collins. Trying to beat Jenkins to the rim.
Good work by Collins just then to hide the basketball. Knew Jenkins was coming up on his right-hand side. When you're going to the basket and you recognize a player coming up on you, have to put the ball on the left and really almost put it under your shirt.
Deflection off the Dean pass, and Air Bear gets called for the foul.
And you see the big steal here in the defensively, the deflection. And watch coming down the middle of the floor, and watch where Collins puts the ball. Right now, he tucks it to his left side on the hip. It's going to go away first. allows the defender to go by, and then you have free, clear sailing right to the hoop.
Louisville has suffered five straight losses on the road. You know, last season, the Cardinals would go on late game runs to pull out wins. It's been exactly the opposite this year.
Personnel changes have a little to do with that, huh?
Sure do.
Injuries, newcomers, about 7 of their 14 players are newcomers.
They've had damaging losses to St. John's, Rutgers, Syracuse. And that's why they are sweating it out to make the Big East tournament. Leaning attempt doesn't go from Jenkins, and the follow goes down for Farley.
Good work on the offensive glass. I think Louisville understands if they're patient against this zone, they'll be able to tuck the ball into the seams a little bit, and then they need guys to go and react and get it.
Louisville is shooting 9 of 18 from the field, but just 1 of 6 from three-point territory. Here's Beilon. Coming up on 4 minutes to play in this first half. Beilon working against Jenkins. Jumper for Young. He's got it for three.
When I've gotten a chance to watch Young play, he's always been a nice contributor for this West Virginia team.
Quick pop, does not go from the outside. Dean is open, that's a three, and it rims in. The all-time leader in threes at Louisville, Tyquan Dean.
Farley continues to be a factor. That trip on the offensive glass, it's a little thing in basketball, but you get a second opportunity, you walk away with 3 points on that possession.
26-22.
Have had success with Pitsnoggle down deep.
And a collision. Kanzi trying to force his way in. And a foul. To Rick Pitino about Padgett, he said after the UConn game coming up, they'll take him to New York to have that surgery performed by Dr. Norman Scott.
He got to the point where he wasn't practicing. He was basically playing in games, and then he came into a practice the other day, and they just decided to put him on hold. I mean, he's just really not fair. Good decision by everybody involved.
Backdoor cut. Collins unable to handle it. Out of bounds. Coming up singular at the half, join Greg Gumbel and Seth Davis. All the scores and highlights, plus another edition of Tourney Time with Seth and Clark Kellogg, and a singular Naismith watch update. It's coming up on Singular at the half. Dean resets with Williams outside. Ball movement. Jenkins the jumper. And rebound taken by Young for West Virginia.
Pretty good balance on the floor. Against zones, you generally go the other way, betting pretty well.
Gansey unable to hit. Dean looking to break out for Louisville. Dean gets around Beilon, but can't hit the running one-hander. Beilon the other way. The cut. Kanzi. And a foul. As Kanzi was going hard, he picks up the offensive foul.
That's a little bit of recognition by both Kanzi and Beilon. You see where that pass comes in. And Kanzi right there, it did have a real good feel from where the defender was. He caught it, put the ball down, and you notice just slightly his head looking down after the catch. Boy, no man's land, it goes the other way.
First foul on Kanzi. It was Farley who took that hit in the lane. Down to 2:18 to go in this first half. Jumper, Jenkins. That rainbow jumper goes for three.
What they have figured out from that right corner is that if you put a little ball pressure on the front perimeter guy and put a spot-up shooter in the corner, good things will happen because Collins can't run the baseline that far.
And the Cardinals are within one with under 2 minutes to go in this first half. Pitsnoggle tosses out of a double. Kanzi open look. For Kanzi.
And a confident 3-2, Ian. As that ball was swung around the perimeter, you could see it across the court from where we're sitting, that Ganzi's eyes were lit up saying, just get it to me, I'm ready to shoot. And the key thing being, I'm ready to shoot. Then when you catch it, it's automatic.
The senior from Olmsted Falls, Ohio, is the high man here today with 11. What a great feel for the game Kanzi has.
Both ends of the floor, no doubt.
Dean, good fake, and the three is on target for Tyquan Dean. He's in double digits with 10.
Well, over his last 7 games, he's really been on a roll, shooting the ball from long range at about 44%. So, fighting off that ankle injury about 7 or 8 games ago, where he missed a bunch of games. What was it, 3 games?
Yep.
Pit game, I think he played only 12 minutes.
Young, dishing, Pitsnoggle caught underneath. creates along the baseline.
That's where he plays like he's 5'10", really. You gotta love it. In trouble a little bit along the baseline. He doesn't stop. He doesn't stop and say, hey, I'm a 7-footer. I'm not supposed to do that. Why not? A little bounce and go.
Both teams shooting 50% from the field. Williams, good look at a three. Terrence Williams knocks it down. And we are tied at 31. The shot clock has been turned off. Final seconds of this first half at the Coliseum. What month is this?
I don't know. It really feels like it, doesn't it, March? Wow. These guys want to get to the locker room, though. This has been a pretty good pace.
8 seconds left. Collins, 3 seconds. Ganzi straight away. Can't hit. And rebound controlled by Louisville. West Virginia and Louisville tied at 31.